And welcome to another episode of Dena Talks DNA. Today we're going to be going over very basic genetics. Now when I say very basic, I mean very basic. Of course it's a lot more complex than this, but this is the bare bones minimum that you need to know to understand what you're doing when you're doing genetic testing. What is genetics and what are they actually looking at when you do a test? So we're going to start out with cells.
Our body is made up of things called cells. We have trillions of them, and in every single cell, we have things called chromosomes, which are actually packages of information. If we were to look really closely at a chromosome, we would notice that it's just very tightly wound up DNA. A segment of DNA is called a gene, and that's where the word genetics comes from. So genes are made up of an alphabet of four letters we call nucleotides. Now, an easy way to remember this is that every cell has its own library of information, of recipe books, and every chromosome is a recipe book. And every gene on those chromosomes are like the recipes inside of a book, whereas the nucleotides are like the letters on the pages of the recipes.
If you were to ask several people to give you recipes for a cake, each one would be slightly different, but in the end, all the recipes would still make a cake.
It's the same thing with our genes. There's no perfect version of any gene. There's lots of different versions that end up making the normal protein as the end product. So typically, a gene codes for a normal protein. But when there's a mutation or a change in that gene, it may cause an abnormal protein or no protein to be made.
So it's these mutations that we look for when we're doing genetic testing.
So how was that? Did you learn a lot? Do you want to learn more? Did I pique your interest? Subscribe.